Okay, today I'm reacting to a special type of facial that Sandra Bullock got. It involves microneedling. Let's hear and watch this, and then I'm going to talk to you about how it applies to you, what exactly this is, and give you a couple different options. If you like what these Hollywood people do and you want to know what they do to look so young, let's dive in.
Months ago, Kate Blanchett admitted to that Sandra Bullock and her went and got a certain kind of facial in New York when they had some downtime shooting Ocean's 8. So Sandra sat down with Ellen and explained exactly what it was.
Well, it's this way in which one forces through microneedling. It's like a little roller with these, some of you, I think many of you know it, and it pushes through the skin and ruptures the collagen and then boosts it. You look like a burn victim for a day, but then it pushes
the skin. What are you pushing into the skin, Sarah?
Serum.
Sandra?
Yeah.
What are you pushing into the skin?
She's a little apprehensive to say.
Well, you push in whatever the facialist would like to insert into your pores.
But what is it?
It is an extraction from a piece of skin that came from a young person far, far away, and they somehow figured out how to extract
its foreskin from a Korean baby.
Far, far away. So foreskin will go on in this, but what they're talking about is EGF, epidermal growth factor, and growth factor microneedling facial. I'll tell you more about some different options, but that's where this is going.
That's what it is.
It's not like I'm lying there with little pieces all over my face.
Of collecting it and having it for, we'll do something with this.
And why didn't we come up with that?
Right.
Yeah. And so we call it, I call it the penis facial. And I think when you see how good it is to your face, you too will run to your local facialist and say, give me the penis.
Now you could go to a facialist, but you can actually do it at home with a derma roller with growth factors from human bone marrow derived growth factors, which I prefer, and they're made in the USA and it's a controlled environment. So they do offer these in clinics. You hear a lot more also about something called exosomes, but you can do this safely at home. I'll put a link below to exactly what you can purchase if it's something you're interested in. And at the end of the video, I'll put a link also to a complete video on human bone marrow growth factor, microneedling, and skincare. Let's move on. It sounds like she liked the result. She looks fabulous. Watch this.
Wow. Jamie says, hell no, I'd never have that done. I don't know if it works. I mean, Hollywood, they all look great. Sandra looks great.
Yeah.
So if it works, you don't have to know what...
If I had the choice between having foreskin injected into my face or botulism...
Right.
Right?
It's probably very expensive.
I'm sure it is.
So, listen to that. But this is what the public would think. So, Botox is one of the most studied drugs on earth, but... cells and growth factors from a foreskin, you don't know where it came from. No, you'd rather get Botox if you're picking and choosing for safety per se. So growth factors, we talk about them all the time. They can come from fat cells, bone marrow, or areas of the skin like the foreskin, and foreskins are often discarded. That's why it's a good source of it. Now, we talk on this channel a lot about microneedling. It works great. What's the slip that you use? In this case, growth factor stem cells from somebody else, an exogenous source. But remember, with your blood draw, so you know PRP, platelet-rich plasma, and you also know the newest generation of platelet-rich fibrin, which I call Plasma Glow, and you can go to plasmaglow.com if you want to read more about that or watch my videos on PRP versus PRF. But you have your own growth factor stem cells and exosomes that you can use to rejuvenate your own skin. You don't need somebody else's. So I much prefer that. When you start talking about the world of exosomes and growth factors, what they are, signals in the body, in the blood, that signal your skin to rejuvenate. And when you couple them with stem cells are cells that can grow into anything else in your body. So they're pluripotent stem cells. It's a cell that can grow into skin, into your liver, into your kidney, into other things. When you cut yourself, of course, your skin rejuvenates. What they're used for here is the micro holes in the skin with the microneedling need to heal. You get growth factors and stem cells, and if you add more through the foreskin growth factors, then of course you, or the idea is you get beautiful glowing skin with stem cells and growth factors. So I advocate using your own. You have your own in your own body. Whenever you get another source of it, there could be impurities, infection, God forbid, disease that come through in those. Often they're highly purified, but what these two are talking about too is a good point. There's a lot of regulation around it. Exosomes and growth factors can certainly be taken off the market at any time because they can start to make claims that lead to problems with the FDA and FDA sourcing. So I love microneedling, collagen induction therapy, CIT. Of course, Sandra looks great. She went for the growth factor microneedling. A lot of people do. Keep in mind, you can get it with PRF, platelet-rich fibrin, and or growth factors that are made in the United States. These ones were from Korea, in LA, in California, in a lab, and I have those on my website, so you can read more about those. Do you like microneedling? Do you like growth factors and exosomes? Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.